Hey, what's up guys? I'm Theo Joe, and today I have a tutorial that I think is gonna excite a lot of people, myself included. You know, years ago, Gigabit seemed like a complete dream, and recently we know that it has been rolling out to several select cities, leaving many of us wondering when our city is gonna be getting Gigabit, if at all. But here I'm gonna tell you something that the internet companies really don't want you to know how to do, and that is how you can get Gigabit probably right now for free without having to pay up, even if your internet company does not offer a gigabit plan. Now, I'm sure for most of you, this is gonna sound too good to be true, but I really ask that you just bear with me through this video. I think you're gonna be glad you did and also be really surprised about just how easy it is. So let me explain. Most of you know that when someone is lucky enough to be offered gigabit service, they sign up with their ISP, the internet company comes to their house and gives them some sort of special equipment that supports the connection. It could be a special router or even a whole new fiber optic box. But either way, once the installation is done, they then have gigabit internet. The key thing to understand though is that your actual physical internet connection from your house to your ISP is already able to support gigabit connection. You just don't have the necessary equipment. You just need the special router that the ISP will provide to support that connection so you can use it for yourself. But here's the secret. Your internet connection right now is probably already able to do gigabit, even if your internet company does not offer that speed. And you can actually upgrade your current router right now to use that maximum gigabit speed without getting any special equipment from your internet service provider. Okay, by now you're probably tired of hearing me talk, so let's just jump right in and I'll show you how to do it. It's really surprisingly easy. Now, you're only gonna need two things. First, the router provided to you by your internet company, and second, a USB flash drive of at least 1 gigabyte. You see, the reason your current router isn't able to yet handle that gigabit connection is it doesn't have enough processing space, better known as ID10T processing memory. And if you're clever, you can probably already see how this USB drive is gonna play into this. To use a 1 gigabit internet connection, you need at least 1 gigabyte of processing memory, and we can provide that with a USB drive. So all you need to do is go to your router and look for a USB port on the back, then plug in the USB drive of at least 1 gigabyte. Then you can proceed to cycle the router by unplugging it, waiting 30 seconds, and plugging it back in. As I mentioned, you need to use the router that was provided to you by your internet company. If you go out and buy a router yourself at the store, this isn't gonna be compatible. And if you find that your router does not have a USB port on the back, unfortunately, that means that your connection does not support gigabit at all. Now, after you plug in your USB drive and cycle your router, you're ready to go to your computer and check out your brand new internet speed. And let me show you a before and after of the results I got when I did this. Here's the before, and as you can see, it was already a pretty good speed, but of course, I can always use more internet speed. Why don't we take a look at what happened afterwards? And holy cow, I could hardly believe it myself. Now, obviously, it's not a full gigabyte exactly, but heck, it's close enough. And I'm not exactly complaining. So there you have it. You are most likely now able to get free gigabit internet service when you probably thought it was years away from your town. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up so I know you liked it, and also let us know how it went down in the comments section. If you want to continue watching and check out some other tutorials, I've got those on the right hand side. You can just click those or look in the description for the same link, like if you're on a phone. If you want to subscribe, I make new videos Monday, Wednesday, Friday, so I think it should be worth it. And I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys either here on YouTube or on Twitter. So thanks for watching. I will see you next time. Have a good one.